Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Have you ever thought about how much weathering can be done with a single bottle of enamel wash or one tube of oil paint? Well, me neither, until I painted this Crusader Mark III. If you've seen the previous episode, I was talking about things like limited color palette and subtle weathering which won't hide the post-shaded surface. Well, this led me to an idea. How many effects can be achieved with one weathering color? In this case, a bottle of enamel wash. Obviously, this model won't be just about one color, and I'm gonna add more effects in the upcoming videos, because this is a whole series about this model, but I really wanted to give it a try and see if we could possibly create a presentable model using one product. Which, I don't know, could be useful for someone who's on a budget, or someone who likes to keep weathering simple and subtle. So with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, let's take a look at it. My friends, tonight will be all about this bottle of DAK wash from AK. But before we get to it, there's one minor adjustment I have to make. This is a highly contrasting paint scheme, and as such, I felt like I should give it a quick filter. This doesn't have to do anything with the main focus of this video, and I could theoretically apply it in the previous episode, because filters, they're technically a part of the initial painting process, because their main purpose is to alter the tone of the base coat, or subtly unify contrasting colors, which is the case of this model. Sandy colors are warm, while blacks and grays are cold, and a grayish, sand-ish filter will give them a unifying tone. So with this quick adjustment out of the way, we can proceed to the main event. So, enamel wash for Deutsche Afrika Korps vehicles. It's a generic black-brown color, and we could use a black-brown oil paint as well, but I simply chose this product because I like working with enamels whenever possible. It feels more convenient to me, but this is just my personal preference. However, in this case, I had to dilute the wash with enamel thinner in order to make it less intense, because otherwise the contrast would be too strong. So, the first and most obvious effect is pin wash. This outlines every surface detail, and the point is to use a diluted paint, like an oil or enamel, and just gently touch the detail you want to outline and the paint will flow around it. The main advantage of commercially available enamel washes is the simple fact they're pre-mixed and ready to use. This is very convenient in case you're a beginner or you just don't have enough experience with weathering techniques. It's easier to get familiar with the technique using a product specifically designed for the task, which will work as intended, instead of mixing your own concoction without knowing what color to use or how much diluted it should be. Cleaning up the excess wash is equally as easy. Just let the paint get dry to the touch and then gently wipe away the excess with a clean brush with small amount of enamel thinner. Not too much, the brush shouldn't be saturated with it because then it would spill all over the surface and make the wash even messier. So just a small amount. And in fact, I sometimes vary the amount of thinner depending on the effect I want to create. But more on that in a moment. And if we're going for a really subtle look, and also want to use full potential of this technique, we can actually dilute it more or less depending on the type of detail we're outlining. For example, I use the wash pretty much straight from the bottle around deep panel lines and hatches, diluted as I've shown you around bolts and rivets, and very, very diluted in shallow places like around these weld beads. Varying the opacity will create much more interesting results, and in fact, if you remember some of my previous videos where I often refer to the model right after the pin wash as sterile or too pristine, I think it was actually because of this very reason that I used the same wash with the same opacity all over the model. But alright, enough about washes already. Let's make some more interesting effects, such as streaking. This can be done in a couple of ways. A precise streaking effect running down from a certain detail, or subtle and random streaking to break up a large vertical or sloped surface. The latter, which I'm creating right now, is slightly easier because we just need a random blotch of wash which we're gonna drag down. I actually did this effect by accident while I was cleaning up the excess paint on these sand shields. And as I was removing it, I thought, what if I did something more creative here? Needless to say, this effect can be created while you're blending the wash, or you can do it afterward. So, you know, just add a small blob of wash, give it a minute to dry, and start dragging it down. The best way to control the streaks is to blend them from both sides. So in this case, I started by dragging them from the right side, and then I flipped the model upside down and blended them more from the left side. This is also a very effective way to control their direction, because understandably, streaking effects on a tank should be vertical and always follow gravity, so straight down. Unless, of course, you're creating a vignette with an abandoned tank left in a pit or on a hill or something. The only rule, so to say, I'd say is even these subtle random streaks should start somewhere logical. Like in this case, the sheet metal plating holding the sand shield on the mudguard, or here at the back running down the angled engine hatches. Okay, so what about those more precise streaks? These usually run from details like bolts, rivets, or grab handles. Because I needed this effect to be more controlled, I used the thick paint from the bottom of the lid, which won't spill all over the surface. The process is exactly the same as before. It will just take a few more passes to achieve a nice subtle effect, because the paint we're working with is more opaque. There are several important things here. Making sure the streaks are spaced irregularly. This means it might not be the best idea to drag them from every single bolt on the model. Rather, picking out random ones will look more natural and interesting. And also, their size should be random as well, which means they shouldn't be equally long, especially those which are next to each other. This can be easily done by just wiping the lower half of the streak away and then gently feathering it one more time. I tried this effect previously with oil paints, and although it's just my personal opinion, but I think enamel wash is actually better for this technique. I find it easier to blend it and it doesn't leave a faint trace like some oil paints might do. So, what else can be done? Speckling. This technique can be used to quickly add more visual texture to otherwise flat and uninteresting places. Of course, it's best to use a very diluted wash mixture, because the point is to create a very subtle effect which won't make the model darker, but instead just add a few random, barely noticeable stains. They can be blended further with enamel thinner, or we can just remove those which we're not happy with. Using the thick paint from the bottom of the bottle cap, once again, we can create heavier effects representing grime and grease. Basically, this entire panel around the turret ring will be mostly out of sight, so I wasn't afraid to add lots and lots of grime. This can be also enhanced with speckling, but this time I used the wash straight from the bottle. The same effect can be achieved around fuel tank caps. Just apply the thick paint in random shapes, and then blend it by gently tapping its edges with a soft brush and tiny amount of enamel thinner. Using the wash straight from the bottle can be effective if we want to add heavier streaking effects. Just like on the underside of the turret, which is a quite specific effect, but I actually noticed it on the real tank. In this example, I just painted lots of random lines, and then I feathered them the same way as before. Also worth mentioning is this fake panel line. I didn't want to spend time scribing it when I was building the model, because that would mean replacing the bolt detail as well, but even then I already knew it would be easy to create a fake impression of the missing detail with carefully applied and blended wash. I know, you can notice it's just a painted one if you look up close, but when the turret isn't upside down, it looks almost like a legit thing. I also wanted to have a large dark stain on the front armor plate. Not only I've seen something like this on another photo, but it'll make sense considering I'll have a few oil canisters there once the model is finished. British flimsy cans were very unreliable and used to leak all over the place, so it only makes sense to have something like this here. Most of the stain will be covered up anyway, so hey, at least we'll know it's there. Anyway, I think that's gonna be it, my friends. I hope you found this episode helpful or at least interesting to watch, because even if it might seem like a typical pin wash video, it's actually more than that. Or at least I tried to make it more than that, because otherwise I wouldn't release this as a separate video. Having a single color or using a single painting technique and taking it further is actually quite enjoyable, because it gives you more opportunities to get creative and figure out different things which can be achieved. Like I said in the beginning, I'm gonna continue with the weathering process the next week, specifically chipping, rust zones, I'll try to be very subtle this time, and I'll also paint all the surface details and stowage. So the model will be ready for dust effects the week after. But again, if you're into more subtle or limited weathering, or you're just on a budget and don't have tons of different weathering products, you can actually do quite a lot with just one bottle of wash. Or a tube of oil paint, if that's something you prefer more. Anyway, thank you my friends, also a big extra chunky thank you to my generous patrons who make this weekly show possible, and if you'd like to get more content and in return help me make these videos, you can take a look at my Patreon page and maybe you'll find one of the rewards interesting. Maybe you'll find one of the reward tiers interesting. There's stuff like almost daily photo updates, which is like a constantly updated blog with photos straight from the workbench, very big and very nice photos like the one in the background right now, 1 week early ad-free videos, and we can also get in touch through DMs. I think that's quite a lot of stuff for somewhere between $1 and $10 a month, so again, if you'd be interested, I'll appreciate it even if you just give it a look. Anyway, now it's really all I've got for you tonight, ladies and gentlemen, so thank you again, have a great weekend, take care, have fun with your models, give the video a like if you liked it, or a dislike if you didn't like it, XOXO, and I'll catch you again the next week, cheerios.